Hello guys, welcome back as usual. Continuing on with Half-Life 2. This is part number 15, if I'm correct. Really, am I correct? Yeah, so we're inside the town hall and we are on our way to destroy or shut down the suppression device. Not as tired this time around, so hopefully there won't be any yawning. Although I did just eat, so I am full, if you like. Anyway, how is everybody doing? Just finished off Rockstar's double XP week, and now they've released another double XP week, so I'm permanently fused to my chair. Just activate those mines. Get some health quickly whilst I can. Now that drop ship won't do us any harm. It's just dropping off a couple of dudes. Just quickly grab some more health whilst we fight that drop ship. The gunship even. That just went straight through that building by the looks of it. Yeah, it does take a fair few rockets. It's about five, I believe, on normal. I'll have to count sometime. Then I notice the dudes coming around, and they seem to be invincible to rockets for some reason. Just finally get someone. That guy, he doesn't want to die. I know someone low health, so I'll go hide. I don't really have any interesting little bits and pieces for this particular section. I don't know much, or if there's any sort of background development, developmental stuff going on for this. Crossbow is quite a bit different from the one in Half-Life. Although in Half-Life it's supposed to be a tranquilizer rifle, and this one it's a fully a killing, you know, a completely lethal crossbow. Let me get my words out. It's a problem with the SMG. It's so inaccurate that you'll be shooting some guy for quite a while. Excuse me. Just a can of drink. 'Cause I love drink. Especially the stuff that slowly kills me. Anyway, I was just having a quick look around for any health. Doesn't seem to be any, so I just picked up a piece there. When you're low on health, you don't really want to rush out anywhere. Now then, now that we've disabled the suppression device. We can really move people through now. Combine's gonna feel the squeeze. We dropped a crate of rockets coming across the plaza. If you can make it there, you should have everything you need to take down these striders. Follow Freeman. Now that we've disabled the suppression device, we are now back onto the city streets. And this section is going to be an absolute clusterfuck. Excuse me. When I was recording this game play, the amount of times I died was unbelievable. I think I died about 4 or 5 times just in this one section. This section's is always a nightmare for me. I really, really despised this chapter. This chapter is one of the worst. Just because there's too many striders and everything's out in the open, and there's barely any cover. There's death number one. I just wanted to see if I could go back inside, but I couldn't. There's death number two. There's going to be about 6 or 7 deaths, I reckon. It's gonna be a while. I'll have to try to keep you entertained as such. It's a good thing I've got nothing to say. Valve VR came out recently. That was about $7.99. It's far too much. Sony's working on their version, so we'll see how much that costs, and if it works with the PC. I'm sure someone will code it to do so if it doesn't. Someone in the community, although they say the PS4 is closely related to the PC in terms of architecture, so it might work. It might almost be plug and play, more or less. Here's hoping, find they're cheaper than everybody else's. I haven't had a chance to use Sony's VR headset. I've used the Oculus, and that was a really good experience, and I believe Valve's is going to be equal to that. Sony is going to be a little bit different, difficult to say at this juncture. Anyway, we're taking down the striders, or trying to. The problem is they seem to like lock onto you as soon as you come around the corner. So it's quite a pain in the ass to fight them. see like that. That's what, number three? Number three or four? I think it's number three. So I try my best with this for a bit, trying to take them down. The problem is they do respawn after a while as well. So that's an issue. And I'm dead again. I think this is the last time I try it, and then I get fed up, and I decide to revert my save. And because I run out of rockets, I try everything to take him down. Later on, you can take Stratus down with one combined energy ball, but here it's three. Well, more than three, obviously. I get stuck on a door. But yeah, it's basically impossible to do this area without getting hit. Or dying at least once. And I've played this game over and over again since it was released. I've played it multiple times. So yeah, like I say, I know this game back to front. Back when I enjoyed Valve's work, although now they seem to be doing it. And that one just came out of nowhere. Oh, I took longer than I thought, actually did. I decided to run somewhere else this time. And they get shafted. Just not in the most pleasant way. There, you got a guy over there that's shooting him. So you got a teammate over in one of those buildings that keeps distracting him, but... It's not really enough. They don't seem to be firing submachine guns or something, or rather, at him. I just tried to break this table just to give myself some more room, but it turns out the table doesn't break. The striders and the gunships, you may notice they all look alike, and they're all from the same race. That they combine of enslaved. They seem largely robotic, but they are sort of like a bug type alien. It's possible that the combine welded the bits of the bits of metal and the armor on after they captured them, which is most likely considering their guns. They seem to have guns welded onto them. But yeah, those things are actually organic in nature. get caught in the geometry there. I was just hiding in case they didn't shot me straight away, like that. And that's him down. Have a little cheeky save, just so I don't have to do it all over again. And another one. After those deaths, I was a little bit cautious. And I'm still going to get screwed by the looks of it. That thing must be the most clumsy enemy. When I decided to run. Oh yeah, this is another couple of deaths I get. I try to run. I know there's an ammo crate for rockets around the corner, so I try to make it to there because that's got there's some health packs and infinite rockets over there. So I try to get over there for those. Of course, it didn't work out too well, and I abandoned that idea shortly after. I decided to go back, see what I could find here. I decided to try and get back to. Try and get back to that area. Of course, this didn't work either. I got stuck here for a bit because I quick saved like an idiot. Try to see if there's any rockets left over from before, but then another one of those guys spawned. Another one of the Striders. Yeah, it's gonna take me a while here. Yeah, I get killed a couple of times and then I just decide to revert my save. Luckily it doesn't take too long, otherwise I would have cut that out if it took 2 minutes or so to. Try it again. Of course I do. And for some reason that time it just instantly died. Well, after two hits, and now I can finally get around to the health and the rockets I was after. And it's that guy again throwing more crates at us. And then he dies, unfortunately. At one point, that Strider pulse cannon, that was going to be its main weapon. Obviously, it's ridiculously overpowered, so Valve kept it for scripted events. And then I tried to rush in, and obviously I died again. This section causes me many, many deaths. I should also stop breathing so heavily into my mic because it's probably horrible distortion. In the future I'll try and mute my mic when I need to breathe. It's a pain in the ass when you can't see what you're doing. it's just a case of running along, hoping that you don't get hit, and sort of hiding. But like I say, the striders are pretty much just lock onto you as soon as they see you. So that's a real pain in the ass. I was just clearing the room out here just so I had more space to move around. I could have used it to block up the gaps, but I was fine just chucking the stuff out. So that guy, the other strider's got me pinned down, so I look for the other one to see if I can take that out. I was hoping for some rockets in the corner, but that wasn't the case. Actually, there's a health first aid station there. But yeah, the striders do take their fair share of rockets. It's a shame we don't have any rope and ships. But yeah, that strider knows where I am now. But yeah, anyway, if you're unaware, the Combine are basically just they just basically conquer other races and then they sort of do surgery on them, you know, dissect them, cut them apart, and then force them to work for the Combine, force them to join the Combine. Some of humanity, that's happened to some of humanity, which you'll see later on, in a later part. But I can't quick save too often now. But that's pretty much it for this episode. Anyway, that's it. Going to be it for this episode. Thanks, as always, for watching and sticking with me. There's at least two people watching this series besides me, so thanks to the two that are watching, or at least clicked on the link once, even if it's for 30 seconds or so. But that is it. Thanks for watching.